Go.
Hello, welcome to the Bistecca Kitchen. My name is Chef Patrick, and I'm going to be demonstrating for you how to prepare your corzetti pasta this evening. So we have our corzetti ingredients here. This is our hand stamped and rolled corzetti. This is our walnut pesto. You'll have a little pipette of essenza balsamic and extra virgin olive oil for finishing. This here is your brown butter. It's emulsified with lemon juice and some salt. And then some gorgonzola dolce to put on top of your pasta. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to throw the pasta in. Corzetti is a slightly thicker pasta, so it will take a little bit longer than some other fresh pastas to cook, but it will still be fairly quick, probably about a minute and a half. You want your water to be well seasoned, very heavily salted. This will help season your pasta as well as season your sauce as you put the pasta in the sauce.
You've already done all the hard work of browning the butter.
That is correct. This butter is browned already, and the lemon juice is emulsified into it. So when you throw your pasta in, you should see a little bit of a sizzle action happening. That's what you want. You want your pasta to fry a little bit in the butter. Corzetti is originated in the Liguria, which is in the northern part of Italy. You classically see it with either a butter sauce or a pesto, sometimes with a walnut cream sauce. But here we're doing a walnut and a pesto, so you kind of get the best of both worlds. The flavor of the pesto as well as the walnut. And the stamp that you see on the corzetti, it can be anything from a family crest to a regional coat of arms.
Chef, I noticed that you're using a non-stick pan. Is that recommended?
I would recommend it. It's not necessary, but I recommend it just because sometimes your pasta will stick to a metal pan. So this just gives you that little bit of extra security. If you don't have a non-stick pan, you can use a metal pan. Just make sure that you're keeping your pasta floating at all times. So I'm going to add my pasta in here. I'm just going to toss it around in our brown butter. Make sure we get everybody in the pan. And you won't necessarily use all the sauce with this. The pesto is going to really be our sauce. But we want to make sure that the pasta has a chance to marry with our brown butter.
This particular one, you wouldn't use any pasta water?
You don't need to. You're welcome to. But I think it actually works better as a broken sauce. If you have your brown butter, and you're going to put the pesto over it. That's what's really going to give you most of your flavor for this sauce. So it only takes a moment to fry your pasta in your butter. As you saw, I kind of pulled it away from the fire so it doesn't flame up too much. Just make sure you're being careful at home. And then as you're plating it, I'm going to use this beautiful Richard Tenori plate. Just kind of lay your pasta out. I like to kind of lay it out sort of flat. I think you get a nice image of the little stamps that are on here. This one has a nice little fleur-de-lis, which is kind of a Medici family take, I guess. And the back side of it is kind of like a spiral. It's kind of cool.
Did this pasta actually take on a little crispiness too?
Yeah, absolutely. It will kind of fry up a little bit. It should be kind of soft. It should be a little crispy almost on the outside and kind of chewy on the inside.
And that is the color that you're looking for on the butter?
Yeah, your butter will brown. Like I said, it is already brown butter. Just kind of lay them out, spread them out a little bit. You can put a little bit more of the butter on the plate. But again, we're going to cover this with our pesto, and that's what's going to give it flavor. Spread them out so you can see them a little bit better. I'm going to top it off with pesto. You can just kind of dollop it on or pour it on wherever you like.
And this flat pasta, definitely you like it on a flat plate rather than a bowl.
I do. You can put it in a bowl, but then you don't kind of get the visual of the presentation that you get by kind of spreading it out a little bit. You kind of want to see that stamp that you see on each piece.
What's in your pesto?
This pesto has a little bit of parsley, basil, and mint. A little bit of Parmesan cheese, and then, of course, walnut, since it is a walnut pesto, and then a delicious finishing oil.
Do you like that chilled or at room temp?
It's best at room temperature, so it's best to leave it out for a little bit before you make your pasta. And that just makes it a lot easier for you to spoon it onto your plate. And then we're going to put a little bit of our gorgonzola cheese here. It's already lightly crumbled up for you. So just kind of sprinkle it around.
And that is a DOP variety rather than a domestic.
That's correct. So this is from Italy.
Much different flavor in those, huh?
Absolutely. For me, it's the richness and the cream that's used in those cheeses. It's just different because it's... The cows eat different grass, so you get a different flavor. And then for your balsamic, just kind of drizzle it over. And same with your olive oil. And your pasta is ready to enjoy. I want to thank you again for supporting us. We really appreciate you guys purchasing our pastas and our tasting menus. We'll be changing them periodically, but this is one we'll have on for at least the rest of this week and probably next.
Looks so good. It looks so yummy. Let's eat it.
Let's eat.